Good morning and happy Memorial Day. Today is the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church. This Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Reverend Thomas J. Fury at the request of Peggy Henson. The entrance hymn is number 198, Immaculate Mary, number 198. Please stand.
In heaven the blessed your glory proclaim. On earth we your children invoke your fair name. Ave, Ave Maria, Ave. Church upon earth, and bless Holy Mary, the land of our birth. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, whose only begotten Son, as he hung upon the cross, chose the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, to be our mother also, grant, we pray, that with her loving help, your church may be more fruitful day by day, and exulting in the lowliness of her children, may draw to her embrace all the families of the peoples. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After Adam had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to him and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked him, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it. Then the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike you at your head, while you strike at his heel. The man called his wife Eve, because she became the mother of all the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glorious things are said of you, O city of God. His fountain upon the holy mountains the Lord loves, the gates of Zion, more than any dwelling of Jacob.
Glorious things are said of you, O city of God.
Glorious things are said of you, O city of God, and of Zion they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High Lord. They shall note when the peoples are enrolled, this man was born here, and all shall sing in their festive dance, my home is within you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine. So they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said, "It is finished." And bowing his head, he handed over the spirit. Now, since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of that week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first, and then of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. As our nation celebrates Memorial Day, in which we pay tribute to all the men and women throughout the decades and centuries that have given their lives for the freedoms that we enjoy and oftentimes take for granted, those who have been slain in war here at home and abroad. And we remember them in a special way today, and it seems very fitting that this Mass setting, Mary, Mother of the Church, which is this memorial, is also celebrated on this day. Because there is a great sacrifice that both Mary gives in her own Son for the sake of the world, for our eternal salvation. And every mother that has ever given up her own son or daughter for the sake of a nation, it's a very painful thing to do. It is a sacrifice greater than any other sacrifice, perhaps, that a mother would ever give. And I just want to take this quote. As you know, I love Fulton Sheen, and he really captures what is taking place in the gospel today as Christ gives Mary to the church as he gives her to John. He says, "From the cross, he completed his last will and testament. He had already committed his blood to the church, his garments to his enemies, a thief to paradise, and would soon commend his body to the grave and his soul to his heavenly Father. To whom then could he give the two treasures which he loved above all others, Mary and John? He would bequeath them to one another, giving at once a son to his mother and a mother to his friend, woman. It was the second Annunciation. Behold your son. It was the second Nativity. Mary had brought forth her firstborn without labor in the cave of Bethlehem. She now brings forth her secondborn, John, in the labors of the cross. At this moment, Mary is undergoing the pains of childbirth, not only for her secondborn, who is John, but also for the millions who will be born to her in Christian ages as children of Mary. Now we can understand why Christ was called her firstborn. It was not because she was to have other children by the blood and of flesh, but because she was to have other children by the blood of her heart. Truly, indeed, the divine condemnation against Eve is now renewed against the new Eve, Mary, for she is bringing forth her children in sorrow. Mary, then, is not only the mother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but she is also our mother, and this not by a title of courtesy, not by legal fiction, not by a mere figure of speech, but by the right of bringing us forth in sorrow at the foot of the cross. It was by weakness and disobedience at the foot of the tree of good and evil that Eve lost the title, Mother of the Living. It is at the foot of the tree of the cross that Mary, by sacrifice and obedience, regained for us the title, Mother of the Living. What a destiny to have the Mother of God as my mother and Jesus as my brother. Our Blessed Mother, Mother of the Church, serves as a reminder to us of our duties to her as the Christian faith. Through her yes to God, her constant yes, this fiat, she is obedient, pure, loving, generous, willing to suffer for others. It is a hallmark of every good mother. And indeed, again, as our nation celebrates Memorial Day,
We should also remember the mothers of all the sons and daughters that died for our freedoms, for the sake of our own country. Oftentimes in wars that were difficult to understand and perhaps even at times hard to justify, yet they made their gift. We should be mindful every day that just as our freedoms that were won for us by Christ on the cross were first won for us by Mary, his mother, who is willing to endure whatever God's plan was going to be at any cost. And she did indeed do that. Today, as our nation celebrates this Memorial Day, we are really called to remember certainly the lives of those who were poured out for us. But in a special way, I think we're also called to remember all those families, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, who also lost so much in seeing their brothers, their sons and daughters, their sisters, give their lives for a nation. What we ought to ask for today, for ourselves and indeed for our entire nation, is that through the intercession of Mary, the mother of the church, that we may have a spirit of gratitude that is so deep and a patriotism that truly is reflective of the love and mercy that we have towards one another and indeed for every other nation, that we may have a gratitude that never forgets those who have given their greatest, the greatest gift, their own lives. We should make sure that we take time in prayer to pray for the repose of their souls and to also remember each and every day in our prayers the men and women who are serving in our nation's military and also the men and women who certainly serve in other capacities who also put their lives on the line for us each day, those who are police and fire and rescue. And lastly, we ought to ask our Lord to give us the courage ourselves to spend ourselves completely for the good of those for whom we care, most especially our spouses, our children, our mothers and fathers, our community and our nation, that our good example, our love and generosity may always be known, seen, and felt, especially for the poorest of the poor. We ask our Lord today to give us every good grace that we need to protect our nation and to preserve us in the virtues of faith, hope, and love. May his peace be with you now and always.
Please stand. With hearts filled with faith and complete confidence in God's merciful love for all of us, we now turn to him with our needs.
For the Pilgrim Church on earth, may God continue guiding us on our journey and help us remain faithful to his gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil authorities, may God give them courage in protecting the dignity and sanctity of life from conception through natural death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all heroes, those who have fallen and died in defense of our country, those whose lives were forever changed after they served and came home, and those serving today around the world, may the example of their sacrifice inspire in us the selfless love of your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, may the Holy Spirit help us to grow in all virtues, especially faith, hope, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us come in faith to the Lord, who graciously hears and answers our prayers. especially for the repose of the soul of Reverend Thomas J. Fury, that he finds fulfillment in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of your intentions you bring to the altar this morning. For all those for whom we have promised to pray, for the needs of our families, our friends, and our nation, and for all those whose lives have been torn apart by war, violence, and oppression, and poverty throughout the world, that their needs may be met, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God and Father, we ask you now to hear and answer these petitions we faithfully bring to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 697, Sing of Mary, number 697.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the whole church.
Receive our offerings, O Lord, and transform them into the mystery of salvation, so that by its power we may be set aflame with the charity of the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Church, and with her may be united more closely to the work of redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to proclaim your greatness with due praise as we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary. Receiving your word in her immaculate heart, she was found worthy to conceive him in her virgin's womb. And giving birth to the Creator, she nurtured the beginnings of the church. Standing beside the cross, she received the testament of divine love and took to herself as sons and daughters all those who by the death of Christ are born to a heavenly life. As the apostles awaited the Spirit you had promised, she joined her supplication to the prayers of the disciples, and so became the pattern of the church at prayer. Raised to the glory of heaven, she accompanies your pilgrim church with a mother's love and watches in kindness over the church's homeward steps until the Lord's day shall come in glorious splendor. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Nelson our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy.
Our communion hymn is number 332, Gift of Finest Wheat, number 332. Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received the pledge of redemption and of life, we humbly pray, O Lord, that with the Blessed Virgin Virgin's motherly help, your Church may teach all nations by proclaiming the gospel, and through the grace of the outpouring of the Spirit, fill the whole earth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael the Archangel,
defend us from battle. Hear our petitions against wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits to prowl about the world, seeking their own souls. Amen. The miraculous medal novena. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created.
And you shall be the face of the earth.
Let us pray, O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant us in the same Spirit to be truly wise, and ever to rejoice in his consolation, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin. O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who have vouchsafed to glorify by numberless miracles the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly implore her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven. With the Father and Holy Spirit, live and reign, God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works have chosen the weak things of the world, that no flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more widely diffused belief in the Immaculate Conception of your Mother, I wish that the miraculous medal be manifested to St. Catherine Labyrinth. Grant, we beseech you, that filled with like humility, we may glorify this mystery by word and work. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, O most compassionate Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your assistance, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we fly unto you, the Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To you we come, before you we kneel, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, the Word incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in your clemency hear and answer them. Amen. The Novena Prayer. O Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus and our Mother, penetrated with the most lively confidence in your all-powerful and never-failing intercession, manifested so often through the miraculous medal, we, your loving and trustful children, implore you to obtain for us the graces and favors we ask during this novena, if they be beneficial to our immortal souls and the souls for whom we pray. You know, O Mary, how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son, who hates iniquity. Obtain for us then the deep hatred of sin and that purity of heart which will attach us to God alone, so that our every thought, word, and deed may tend to his greater glory. Obtain for us also the spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode where you are the Queen of angels and of men. An act of consecration to Our Lady the Miraculous Medal. O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of our affection for us and a constant reminder of our duties toward you.
ever while wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin.
Pray for us who have recourse to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our recessional hymn is number 745, America the Beautiful, number 745.